So in this topic, we'll be discussing about how to diagnose polycystic ovarian syndrome. The usual criteria that we use for diagnosis of PCOS is known as Rotterdam criteria, and there are three things which have to be observed to make a diagnosis of PCOS. The first thing is that the patient should have irregular menstruation. So either she should have infrequent menstruation and very scanty flow, which is known as oligomenorrhea or amenorrhea. The second part is about the symptoms of hyperandrogenism, that is the male hormones should be high and they should have their, we can get to know that the patient is having high male hormones in the body by the evidence of hirsutism, that is the terminal hairs or thick hairs growing in the central body parts like on the chin and on the upper lip and in the central body over the body in the front as well as on the back. When they are there, it is known as hirsutism. Patients can have oily skin resulting in acne, as well as patient can have male pattern baldness known as male pattern alopecia. So these are the symptoms of high androgen levels in the woman body. We can also test for high androgen levels directly by doing the blood sampling of the woman, where we can test for the testosterone levels as well as androstenedione levels. The third important part of PCOS diagnosis is seeing polycystic ovaries in the ultrasound. The earlier criteria of diagnosing a polycystic ovary was seeing more than 12 follicles measuring 2 to 9 millimeter in either of the ovaries or when the ovarian volume is more than 10 ml. However, with the recent ultrasound machines which have a high penetration and high accuracy, diagnostic criteria of polycystic ovary is seeing more than 25 follicles measuring 2 to 9 mm on day 2 or day 3 of the scan or the ovarian volume of more than 10 ml. So to make the proper diagnosis of PCOD, we should have at least 2 of the 3 criteria to be fulfilled. However, in adolescent girls, immediately after menstrual onset, that is menarche, all the 3 criteria should be fulfilled to make a diagnosis of polycystic ovarian syndrome. Thank you.